Alola, welcome to the Lore Pack. My name is Henry Free. Welcome back to My Sweet Roomies. You know, the game. Or the game that you get to love any girl you want at the first half of the game. Great story. Oh god, if I can get the whole picture, that would be helpful. Okay, let's follow the silver ticket. Thank you. I noticed they have like a similar clip. Okay, last episode, we don't know. We just enjoyed this episode. Friend's dad's words flit into my mind. Or felt into my mind. You win. One day you and me were forced to make a painful decision. A shout about open. Ryan? Nothing. Really? Yoi and Sayaka look confused but leave the room. What did you do, man?
Have I still been running?
Yes. The heck? Are you waiting until I go leave and it's just me? I remember Ryan's dad's words again. What a decision. Perhaps this is what he was talking about. The decision is probably whether she'll prioritize her relationship or her dream. At the start, I thought we could do both, but this seems to be a limit. When thinking to myself, I suddenly remember Ren and Yoan. That time, Ren was really trying her hardest to achieve her dream. I definitely felt her strong conviction. It made me want to support her from the bottom of my heart. But she couldn't have changed. I think that to myself, in contrast, what can I do for Ren? What I can do for Ren is...
No.
No!
Excuse me a minute.
Oh. Oh my god. You guys realize I'm actually making good progress in the store this season. This is like, I could make a lot of videos. Here we go. Chapter 47. Because of our love. A few days have passed since Ren started returning home from Camilla. I keep caught my decision for myself and calling him. Ring, ring.
Hello.
Ah, Ren. It's Ren. Can you talk?
Yeah, it's fine. What's up?
I pronounced without speaking. I was wondering if you'll be able to make it home tonight. There's something I want to talk to you about. Ren's voice becomes serious.
Actually, I also want to talk to you tonight.
Really?
Yeah, I wasn't sure when I'd be able to tell you. So it's good timing. Okay, I'll come home to Familia tonight. It might be late then. Let's talk then, okay?
Oh, okay. See you tonight. Beep. I hang up and take a deep breath. I wonder what Ren wants to talk about. She sounded serious. Somehow, I feel a bad feeling about this. No, Ren's news is important to you, but I have to properly convey what I want to say to you. Inside this and with the Ren. Then, that night, I think I know what's going to happen. Oh, why do I get the feeling that Ren is going to have to probably end up meeting Ren, that Ren's probably is going to probably end up moving. Ren comes home just after dinner. After she's put her things in her room. She comes to the room. Home, have you been waiting long? Welcome home. No, not that long. We exchange light words. Ren sits next to me. my god. Oh, sorry. After a moment of silence, Renhead opens her mouth to speak.
I mean, Ryan, I have something to tell you. Dave, it's okay if I talk first.
Yeah, that's fine.
Thanks.
Ryan takes a deep breath when she takes it.
Ryan, I've decided.
Hmm?
I am going to keep commuting to college from Familia.
Wait, I think my I'm surprised when. Ren declares this and smiles at me.
After all, I've been saying, oh, I don't want to be apart from anyone, from everyone ever. And I want to be with you, Ren.
Ren, I'm really happy that she said that. After finding out that she wants to be with me, as much as I love her and goes into it, still, because of her, I think of her so hard, and also I prepare myself in terms of it. Ren, I'm really happy that you want to stay with me, but I think that we should commute to your parents' house.
Huh?
Ren's eyes are open, eyes wide in disbelief. It's painful, but I force myself to keep talking. Because, Ren, I think you should be familiar and return home. Wow, I'm a jerk. Oh, sorry, I'm just messing with him. Ben looks shocked in my words.
Finally her expression changes to one of them. Return home? Ryan, don't you want to be with me?
Of course I do. I want to be with you, but I don't want to force you with my selfish needs. I say that I want to be with her. Ryan will force herself to come and see me. Up until now, that's how it's always been. I don't want to make her do that anymore. However, Ryan can do something about it.
Bye. I don't want to make you lonely if I prioritize my dreams.
I'm happy you said that, but just right, Ren, you'll fall apart.
I'm fine. I'm looking after myself. I won't collapse.
I'm worried about you.
I said I'm fine.
Why do you push yourself so hard, Ren? Well, thinking. I actually asked for it. Ren looks like she's about to cry and says,
I just want to stay by your, be by your side, Ryan. I just want to be by your side.
Here we go.
That's all I want, but why?
Ren's feelings of wanting to be with me hit me painfully. It's probably best to give up, but words don't come out.
Why? How did everything end up like this?
Ren, silly Ren's up front. A painful expression that I've never seen before appears on his face. Oops, I might have said too much. I heard each other, but that's what happens. I hear words that I never hear from my mouth.
If I knew things wouldn't turn out like this, then I shouldn't have aimed to become a doctor.
And what did you just say? Here comes my catch the breath. Maybe she didn't mean to say it. There's still a shock in here. Why did you say that? Dream. You ever came to me afterwards and promised to get where you are today? Say that you regret it? But why would you say such a thing? Sad and painful in my thoughts became jumbled. I can't stop it. Don't say things like that.
But
you can't give up on your dreams or things like that. Also,
what?
Ryan, you don't understand my feelings at all.
Huh?
My head was on fire, but it cools and it was.
It hurt me.
I'm sorry, Ren.
That's it for this episode. Thank y'all so much for watching. Bye, guys.